In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Happy Advent, brothers and sisters. From the story of the little girl and the four candles, we learn that as long as there's hope, there will be love, joy, and peace in our hearts and in our world. Welcome, brothers and sisters, to our midweek Advent celebration of Scripture, Song, and Prayer. In week one, we lit the candle of hope. What is hope? Hope gives us the courage and the strength to face difficulties, challenges, illnesses, and every source of suffering. Hope helps us to not despair, to not give up, to go through the darkness of the tunnels of life, knowing that with God's help we will come out into the light. Hope is never giving up on the gift of life God has freely given to us. In week two, we lit the candle of love. What is love? We ask ourselves. Love is wanting the good of the other as the other and making it happen. God is love, so to love means to love unconditionally and without strings attached, as God loves us. Love means never giving up on each other, just as God does not give up on us. Today we celebrate week three of Advent, and so we light three candles. From the candle of hope, we light the candles of love and joy. We ask ourselves, what is joy? Joy is not the absence of problems. It is the constant reassurance that God is in charge and will not abandon us even when we feel sad, helpless, and discouraged. The consequence of surrender to God is joy. Joy is the infallible sign that we live in the presence and power of God. When we give in to sadness, we turn inwards. When we give in to joy, we turn outwards, like a sunflower towards the bright, shining sun. Joy means never giving up on God and what God can do for us. Let me sing for you, brothers and sisters, a song which says, it only takes a spark to get a fire going, so pass it on.
This happiness that I
The word joy has three letters. J for Jesus, O for others, and Y for you. Together we are joy. The coming of Jesus that we anticipate in the Advent season is the cause of our joy. Jesus is the reason for the season. Jesus is the one who saves and redeems. Jesus makes our joy complete. We now listen to the Word of God, which comes to us from the Gospel according to John. By this is my Father glorified, that you bear much fruit and become my disciples. As the Father loves me, so I also love you. Remain in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will remain in my love, just as I've kept my Father's commandments and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy might be in you and your joy might be complete. This is my commandment. Love one another as I love you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I no longer call you slaves because a slave does not know what his master is doing. I have called you friends because I've told you everything I've heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he may give you. This I command you: love one another. The good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. We now blow out the three candles, only with the firm belief that the light of hope, the light of love, and the light of joy now burn brightly within us. My final song is The Prayer by Andrea Bocelli. Lead us to a In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the